Hey, what's poppin', fellow hunters? This is Sable Final 4, and welcome to part 4 of our All Items Bloodborne walkthrough. On the previous episode, I covered all of the central Yharnam area, and if you followed everything that I did, you should have all of the items. And we also took care of the first boss, the Cleric Beast. We also get this sword emblem, whatever it is, when you kill the Cleric Beast, and it allows you to get this Kirk Hammer. And it also lets you get this 10,000 Blood Echoes keys, which we're not going to get. You can get it, and you can open a gate in the Cathedral Ward area, which is going to be the next area. Let me just go to the doll and level up. She moved from her usual location. So we're going to cash in the Cleric Beast money. The little ones. Looks like she didn't update her dialogue just yet. She will update her dialogue once we kill the next boss, the main boss of this area, Father Gascoigne. But anyway, let me just level up, get a lot of HP, because we're probably going to need it. But yeah, with the sword emblem, 10,000 blood echoes, you can unlock a gate in the next area. But I wouldn't recommend it. I mean, if you like farming and collecting blood echoes, go ahead. But there's just a better way. We can save the money and just open it up in a better way. You don't have to spend the money. But it can make, it gives you more options. Like if you don't want to do what I'm going to do. And just skip an entire area, essentially. Anyway, we're going to, let's see, repair our weapons and stuff. Make sure we're ready. Because we're basically going to fight Father Gascoigne. Now, Father Gascoigne is the main boss that you have to fight in this area to continue. The Cleric Beast is sort of an optional boss. You don't have to fight him, but I recommend it. It's an easy boss. You get some money, and you unlock a few things as well if you want to buy the Kirk Hammer weapon. But Father Gascoigne, we can't really avoid, and this guy is actually a pretty scary boss for a first boss of the game, I guess, like the main boss you're forced to fight against. He's scary. He's strong. Even the music is pretty like intense and scary. And as you guys noticed, I put the little music box we got from the girl in part 2. And we're going to use that. Father Gascoigne is the father of that little girl. And unfortunately, she wants us to find him. But he's basically a full-blown beast at this point. He's gone mad. We're going to have to kill him to continue. And if you use the music box, you'll be able to stun him for a little bit. You guys are going to see once I get to him. But let's first go to our friend Gilbert. His dialogue is updated now that I killed the Cleric Beast. He's going to tell us a few things as we wait for the loading time. Alright, so let's go to him. What do you have to say?
Yes, I see. But the Great Bridge is the only way to the Cathedral Ward. And during the hunt, the bridge is closed. You could try the aqueduct. There's a rather, how shall I put it, colorful area south of the Great Bridge. From there, an aqueduct leads to the Cathedral Ward. Not a place you'd normally want to visit, but I don't imagine you have much of a choice, do you? An aqueduct leads from the town south of the main bridge to the Cathedral Ward. Not a place you'd normally choose to visit, but not much of a choice with the bridge closed.
Alright, now the aqueduct he's referring to is basically all of the area that we went through, you know, with the rats and the mud shit zombies crawling over there. I basically covered all of the central Yharnam area. Unlocked all of the gates and stuff, and we have access to the boss, which we're gonna go through. But he essentially, the game sort of guides you to fight the Cleric Beast first, so, you know, fight that guy because it's easier than Father Gascoigne. And then fight Father Gascoigne himself. Now, if you don't kill Father Gascoigne, Or actually, if you do kill Father Gascoigne, you can actually summon him to help you against the Cleric Beast, I believe, but it's really meaningless, because he's a harder boss than the Cleric Beast. But anyway, got our free stuff over there, and now I'm just going to run past these brick trolls and just go to the elevator and go ahead and fight the big bad Father Gascoigne of the Healing Church. Outsider just like us. Right. Now, I put the music box over there, and this is something that you don't have to use, but it helps if you use it. You can use it, I think, up to 3 times, and he'll just be stunned for a little bit, not know what to do, and then you can get some free damage on him. I think it works 3 times, but I could be wrong. It might just work only 1 time. I only aim to use it like once. Once he transforms, and then we can get a visceral attack on him. You guys are going to see if I don't screw it up. And it is going to be a pretty difficult boss. If you playing the game the first time around, you're probably going to need a few times to kill him. Maybe even take the chance to level up and get powered up if you can. So try and lure the dudes here, but looks like, as usual, the ball didn't get all of them. I don't know why I can't do it. I used to be able to do it so smoothly. Just to make sure all of them get hit by the fire bowling ball. And you don't have to bother with them. But looks like we took some damage. And I'm going to have to spend a few blood vials already. Crap. What can you do? What can you do? If I'm rusty, I'm sort of rusty. Anyway, looks like they did drop a few items. This guy dropped something. Blood vial, probably. Oh, a Molotov. Even better. Since I had to sacrifice a few. So we're going to take care of these guys, sort of blocking our way. Might as well. You can run past them if you want to, but I'd just rather kill them. And just go with a steady pace on the boss. Savor the moment. So, kill this guy from a distance with the whip. Of course, he's gonna get a hit on me. And he kinda backtracks. He's not really supposed to come on the bridge there. Or he looks like he's coming back again. Kill this guy since he wanted to go all the way there. And a few more hits on you, prick. The best thing you can do is try and get like a visceral on him, shoot him in the front, parry him, so that you don't really have to waste all these resources. I mean, I guess you're going to waste a few bullets. Okay, now over here, since I came last time, we went down the ladder to take care of the hippo there, the pig. I got the shit that was here. But over here, we didn't go. And these are the last few enemies over there, chilling by the fire. And then it's the boss. So, I'm gonna go ahead and get a visceral attack on this one over here. No matter what you do, the other guy is gonna notice you. But at least we can take care of the other guy for free. So get a visceral attack and then get the fuck out of the way. But unfortunately, this guy got a hit on me. It's kind of... it's by luck as well, like what he's doing while you're having the visceral attack on the other guy. But anyway, just gonna kill you. Aw, man, I'm just doing such a bad job here. I'll get the hang of it eventually. I'm not this bad, I promise. So this guy's dead. Okay. And... spend a few resources once again. Okay, got them back. And over there is a... well, this guy giving us some more blood vials. And a bolt harner's mark. Usually when you see this, it's almost like a warning of, hey, you want to get the fuck out now. Like there's going to be a boss. It's not always the case, but it's often enough, I guess. So I'm just going to even remove the oil because maybe we'll use a Molotov on him to finish him off. I don't think so, but I guess might as well. And now we're going to watch a pretty fucked up cutscene. This guy's scary, man.
beasts all over the shop. You'll be one of them sooner or later.
Okay, yeah, pretty scary, dude. It's actually one of the few bosses that I can certainly say I get scared playing him at night. And I guess it's the pressure that gets to me. So as you guys can see, he's a hunter just like us, or at least a hunter that went crazy. So he's not really a big monster, although he will transform into one eventually. You can try and get visceral attacks on him, but it's not going to be as easy as other bosses. He's fucking me up big time here. Try and get visceral attacks on him with the gun if you can. And just try and avoid him. It's going to be a fast-paced battle. Just try and attack him, dodge him, attack him. A balance. And once he gets into, like, two quarters of his health, he's going to transform. Now, okay, I made a big mistake here, and we're dead.
Oh, shit. Here we go.
Fuck. All right. So he's the one, the first death of this walkthrough got claimed by him. Damn it, I played him so many times, beat him the first time, and now that I need it for the walkthrough, he actually got me. But don't worry, we're gonna get him, we're definitely gonna get him. Okay, so round one goes to you, Father Gascoigne. Fucking prick. But he is pretty dangerous, as you guys have seen. You can't really make errors against him. Two shots with the axe and you're dead. So let's kill these dudes yet again and go and fight him again. But if you unlocked all of the shortcuts and the elevator like I did, then it shouldn't be a pretty difficult trip. Kill these dudes again. Thank you for the blood vials, since I had to waste a few of them on the boss. Motherfucker. Motherfucker got us, man. Damn. So, we have to go again. So run past these dudes as usual. Not even gonna bother with them. And I'm gonna get my revenge on you, Gascoigne, 100% for making me look bad. So the elevator, as you guys can see, is on the other side right now. The game remembers what you do. So, since I switched it on and I went to the area and then we died, the elevator is still on the other side. So keep that in mind, because other elevators aren't like this one where you can actually just go ahead and fall down and die if you run. So be mindful of that so that you don't lose all of your blood, it goes for nothing. Okay, so let's see if I can finally kill all these dudes the right way, do the bowling thing right. They actually notice me from a longer distance, I don't understand it. But anyway, we gotta sort of buy a little bit of time. So they throw that damn ball. And come on, just die already. Everybody survived again. Crap. So make sure I kill these guys and not die, because I don't want to lose my money. And, okay, there we go. I don't know what it is, but I just can't get the whole bowling streak. All of them die by the fireball. Okay, this one also gave us some bullets, not a vial. And then these guys, am I going to fight him again or am I just going to run? Just fight him again, I suppose. Going to do a visceral on you this time. Time to get serious. Okay, there we go. First time. So this is the most effective way to kill this dude, if you can do it. Visceral attacks, sort of parrying your enemies. I don't want to say it's an advanced tactic. It's something that you're going to have to master to an extent if you're going to get through this game. But it is something not everybody's probably going to do or try and do. Okay, as for these guys, am I going to ignore them or kill them again? I don't even know. Just go ahead, I guess. Free money. Do it right this time. You're not going to get a hit on me. Alright, there we go. So now it's time for you to die as an appetizer before I kill Father Gascoigne. So goodbye, bitch. Give me a few things, maybe a bloodstone shot would be nice. Nope. Alright, and when you do die on a boss, now you get like the white door sort of block in the way, and then you can enter to fight him. So let's go ahead, get our money first, blood echoes. Ah, you got the hit on me. Oh, two hits on me. Great. Great start. Prick. But, yeah, let's take care of him. When you die, I don't know if you guys know this, but you should if you're playing this game. You lose all your blood echoes, which is your money, and then you have one chance to get it. If you die again before you get it, then it's gone forever, and then it's gonna replace with the new amount. Okay. So, I'm gonna fuck you up, whether you like it or not. Motherfucker. So, he's using the axe, and there we go, visceral attack. Should do decent damage since I have a bit of skill. And once you do enough damage on him, and he only has like a quarter of his health left, I think, then he transforms into the really scary dude. And that in that form, he goes even more berserk. I think he should do it right now, pretty close. So I'm gonna try and bash him, do as much damage I can do before, you know, give him a chance to transform. But you know, he's gonna do it, and yeah, I forgot he actually shocks you. So use the music box, go behind him, try and get the damn visceral, but we failed. Fuck. So now I'm just gonna have to finish him off super quick. Man, this is scary as fuck. Goes mad, as you guys can see. Don't let him touch you. Don't let him, like, get a rush attack on you. Otherwise, you're gonna die. If you don't dodge all of those hits, you're dead. And somehow, some way, we did it. Crap. So I fucked up on the visceral attack. Give us the Udon Tomb Key. It's a key. So that we can move forward. Okay, and I get rid of the music box. You're never gonna need it again. So there it is, Father Gascoigne. Didn't actually use too many vials, just three. It's actually less than the Cleric Beast. But, you know, he is going to be much harder for you if it's your first time playing this game. Until you get used to his fast movements. Which aren't really that fast compared to other enemies. And his second form as well, where he goes mad. That's the worst part. Okay, and now, over here, it's the sad reality of this girl's family. This woman here, Red Jeweled Brooch, is actually the girl's mom. Father Gascoigne went crazy. He killed his own wife. He was killing that other dude over there. And unfortunately, that's the sad reality this girl is going to have to face, or not face, because we have a choice. So I'm going to use this red jewel brooch, and if you break it, you get a red blood gem. And at this point in the game, this little gem is going to give us a good enough boost on our weapons. Once you kill Father Gascoigne, we're going to unlock a couple of things here once I get into the next area. We're going to get a tool that lets us equip gemstones on our weapons back at the Dream World, the Hunter's Dream. And we're going to unlock, basically, additional save hubs for other characters. You guys will see shortly. So take a walk through this fucked up graveyard area. Look at all these coffins and shit. As we enter the Cathedral Ward area now. So walk up. Little pond here, anyway. Go up the ladder and claim our bonuses. So you actually have a few choices with the girl, but I guess I'll get to that later. Let's just get our shit here. Now over there is going to be a note, a pretty important one. The Bergenwood Spider hides all manner of rituals and keeps our lost master away from us. A terrible shame. It makes my head shudder. Whatever he said, didn't get to read that. Anyway, So that actually does mean something, but let's not worry about it now. Open up this chest right here, and we're going to get the Blood Gem Workshop tool. This is what we're going to use to put gemstones on our weapons. And now, it's cutscene time. Okay, now the cool thing about this game is that it actually does remember the clothes you're wearing. So on every cutscene, it's gonna basically play the cutscene with the clothes you're wearing, like the attire you're wearing. And this dude sort of
Oh, you must be a hunter. Very sorry. The incense must have masked your scent. Good, good. I've been waiting for one of your ilk. These hunts have everyone all locked up inside, waiting for it to end. It always does, always has, you know, since forever. But it won't end nicely, not this time. Even some folks hiding inside are going bad. The screams of women folk, the stench of blood, the snarls of beasts, none of them's too uncommon now. Yharnam's done for. Tell ya. But if you spot anyone with their wits about them, tell them about this here Erden Chapel. They'll be safe here. The incense wards off the beasts. Spread the word. Tell them to come on over. If you wouldn't mind. I know I shouldn't be asking ya, but if you happen upon someone while hunting, tell them about this here Erden Chapel. If they seem worth being told, that is. Oh, and I do sincerely hope they are.
Strong. Strong, strong English accent, this guy. Okay. So, now, I'm gonna go back to the Hunter's Dream. Because we don't have a choice, we gotta go there first. This game doesn't let you, you know, fast travel from any area you want. But after we beat Father Gascoigne, we unlock this guy over there. He looks pretty creepy, he looks pretty fucked up, but he's a good guy. Let me talk to the doll to level up. Now, this guy, we can send different characters that have the chance to be saved, well, in quotation marks, because nobody's really going to be saved, over there. And depending on the characters you send, you're going to get bonuses for the most part, but there's also one particular character we don't want to send over there in the future. And we also get the option for Yosefka's clinic as well. We're going to go there pretty soon and talk to her again. And you guys might notice a difference. And if you don't notice a difference, then watch the first episode first. And you compare them. Now let me go up and oh, there's German too. Talk about it. Talk to him as well.
The moon is close. It will be a long hunt tonight. If the beasts loom large and threaten to crush your spirits, seek a holy chalice, as every hunter before you has. A holy chalice will reveal the tomb of the gods, where hunters partake in communion. Most of the holy chalices lie deep within the tomb of the gods, and the few that found their way to the surface were lost again in the hands of men. But if the old hunter tales remain true, one is worshipped in the Valley Hamlet. Yet the town is in disarray. It was burned and abandoned for fear of the scourge. Home now only to beasts. The perfect place for a hunter, wouldn't you say? One of the holy chalices is worshipped in the valley.
I just love talking to this guy. Anyway, he sort of hints us at what we're supposed to do next. Go to the old town, Old Yharnam, where it got burned and abandoned. But let me just equip the Red Blood Gem. We can only equip one right now, since I'm at level 2. But okay, what you can do with this little red jeweled brooch we got from Gascoigne's wife. If you don't break it, you can show it to the girl, and she's gonna cry. And basically, you're not gonna get the gemstone. And after that, you know, she's gonna try and leave on her own and try and find them, not really believe you, and then she's gonna die. Now, if you destroy the gemstone, the red jewel brooch, you get the gemstone, then you can't show it to her. So you're just going to tell her you didn't find her parents. And then she's going to try and ask you, you know, maybe they found a place, going to look for them. And you can send her here, Yosefka's clinic, or you can send her to our friend in the cathedral ward. Let me just talk to this bitch real quick.
Oh, well, hello. Splendid. Let me ask you a small kindness. You're soon off to hunt, I presume? Then, if you find any survivors, tell them to seek Yosefka's clinic. Upon my Hippocratic oath, if they are yet human, I will look after them. Perhaps even cure them. This sickness, these beasts, they are not to be feared. This time the night is long. I may be trapped here, but I should do something to help. I'll even offer a reward for your cooperation. Tempted? Well, off you go then. If you find anyone who's still human, send them straight to Yosefka's clinic. You can assure them there's no place safer. Please, do me this service.
Okay, so if you couldn't tell, this bitch is pretty evil, and she's not the same Yosefka that we talked to in the first episode. She's Imposter Yosefka. Essentially, that's her name. Now, I actually do send a lot of characters to her, because a lot of them are pricks anyway, and they don't really do much. That mean old grandma we talked in the second episode, I'm actually gonna send her over there. And depending on, like, if you send them to the dude with the towels in the cathedral ward, you can gain some different benefits. Some of them you gain no benefits if you send them. Some we definitely want to send, and others it's just better to send them to Yosefka and gain some different bonuses. Every character you send on Yosefka, you're gonna get one insight, which is very valuable. I would rather have an insight than some of the other shit that we could gain if we send them to Erden Chapel. So I'm gonna go. Let's talk to this guy too.
With me. I'm afraid I'm of little help now. But before I take this, I make no use of it, but perhaps you. What afflicted me was incurable, but this time gave me hope. Their strange blood bought me time. I was most fortunate. unharmed by the plague of beasts. I can even die human. Don't you worry about me.
Ah, this poor guy, man. Unfortunately, you're in ignorant bliss still. Anyway, he gave us the flame spare. You can actually use that. It spends bullets, and you can use it. Basically, it's a flame spare, flamethrower sort of weapon. I never use it, to be honest, but you could use it if you want to. It's going to do fire damage, so it is going to be effective against beasts. Technically, it is going to be effective in the next area. We're going to go to Old Yharnam, but I mean, don't use it. It's a bad idea. It's kind of slow. Dude's ganging up on you. I mean, maybe it could work, but anyway. So now I'm going to go to the mean old grandma, and I'm going to send her to Yosefka. So as I was saying before I talked to Gilbert, any character you send to Yosefka, you're going to gain one insight. She's also going to give you some other shit like numbing mists. And then when we enter the clinic, go deeper in Yosefka's clinic, because that is a whole stage too, then we can even gain some more shit. But the main thing is that we gain insight if we send her to, if we send characters to her. That's the point. So useless characters like this mean old grandma, I'm going to send them to her, to Yosefka. And plus, they're also bitches to us anyway. Like, wait till you hear what she's going to say to us after we help her. It's crazy. But if you don't send her, and you send her to Erden Chapel, she's going to be giving you sedatives after she loses her mind, and she thinks you're her grandson or something. But she's bad. She's a bitch. So let's talk to her. What an attitude, man. What an audacious attitude after we try and help. But anyway, I sent you to your death, so you'll get what you deserve. And now that we sent her over there, I gotta go to the girl as well. Now, unfortunately, the little girl, no matter what you do, you can't save her. And that's the thing that sucks with this game. It's like, I mean, even this old bitch, if you send her to Erden Chapel, eventually she's gonna die anyway. But you'll get a few sedatives. But the little girl, man, I would like to save, since he's not bad. But we can't save her. No matter what you do, she's going to get a bad ending, too. So let me just go to her. Actually, wait a minute. No, yeah, we went the wrong way. Instead of just going to the lamp, I'm just going to go up. Yeah, kill the beast. That's the best way. And then I'm going to get to the girl. And we will get something out of her, though. Beside this red jewel brooch, I guess, from her mother. So take care of this, guys. Thank you for the blood vials. And get the chance to kill the beasts over here, too, once again. Get some extra blood echoes, too. Always nice. Alright, dude. Took care of you. And now it's your turn. Motherfuckers. Okay. Right. So, come on. Come over here. Hurry up. I need to take care of you. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just I guess do this sort of mini quests with the characters, the little girl and shit. Take care of these things and then I'm gonna call it an episode. We're not gonna have enough time to start with the next area. But it's important you do these quests too, because you gain things, of course, and since this is an all-item walkthrough, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. You can't actually acquire everything in one playthrough. You gotta go to New Game Plus if you wanna get everything. But for a first playthrough, I'm gonna show you guys, at least in my opinion, the best sort of way to handle things if you wanna get the most shit. Like, for example, you know, the mean old grandma, whatever you send her, she doesn't really give you anything exclusive. So you can send her to Erden Chapel if you want to, and she's gonna be cursing you out over there. But since she's just gonna give sedatives, I just send her to Yosefka and get an insight, which is much more valuable. We can acquire a lot of important things with insight. So took care of those guys too. Maybe it's not gonna be in your best interest to handle them like I did, but I have confidence. I know what I'm doing for the most part playing this game. And now it's your turn, big guy. There we go. First try. Die as well. And go talk to my little girl. Okay. Doesn't even have a name. She's just a little girl, I think, the name.
Hello, Miss Hunter. Still can't find my mum. Oh, okay. I can wait. But isn't there something I can do? Maybe Mum and Dad are stuck out there, waiting for me to come and find them. What do you think, Miss Hunter?
Whatever we do.
It's okay. Thank you, Miss Hunter. I love you almost as much as Mum and Dad. And Granddad. Thank you, Miss Hunter. I love you almost as much as Mum and Dad. And Granddad.
Okay, so unfortunately, no matter what we do, no matter where you choose to send her, she is gonna die. If you send her to Yosefka's clinic, she's evil, so she's gonna kill her. If we send her to Erden Chapel, she's gonna die on her way to try and get to the place. But by sending her to Erden Chapel, we have the chance to get one more item from her, which isn't really anything that you can use in-game. It's one of those ribbon things, messenger accessories. So you can dress up the messengers. It's actually what I usually have on after I acquire it. So I'm gonna get it. Now, I think I might have done this once, but I'm not sure. I don't think this works, but maybe it does. You send her to Yosefka's clinic, and then if you go to the hippo, I think you can still get the red messenger ribbon. Or I think you can't get it right now, but you can't get it later on in the future. But anyway, I just sent her to Odin Chapel, and I think this is a good chance now to buy something too. We're gonna get the lamp. So the lamp, hand lantern, you unlock this after you beat the cleric beast. It's part of the sword emblem. And I usually have this on. Give me a little bit of light. It's not going to give us as much as the torch, but you don't have to, you know, it doesn't take up your spot for your pistol. So there we go. Nice and light. And it's good to have light in this game because a lot of places are dark. And if you can see what you're doing, it's better. So after you send the characters and then you just come to the Hunter stream and then go back, sort of reset the, decisions you make get saved, you could say. Like, they take effect, sort of. You gotta leave and come back for them to take effect. Now, if I go to Yosefka right here, the grandma has arrived and died. So let's see what Yosefka.
Oh, hello. You're all right. Very good. She's safe with me now. I presume you're to thank? The treatment is going well. Stabilized, for the most part. Fascinating, really. Here you are, as promised. Oh, thank goodness you came. Be a dear. Find me some more. There may yet be humans out there. If you find them, send them to Yusefka's clinic. I endeavor to treat every survivor there is. So please, be a saint.
Okay, so if you didn't know she was bad news, now you know for sure. But as you guys have noticed, I gained an insight. So I went from 9 to 10. And she also gave us Numb and Mist, which is something that I don't ever use to. If you play online, you might use it against other hunters so that they can't heal. That's essentially what it does. You throw it on somebody and they can't heal for a while. Okay, and now we're going to go to Erden, Tomb of Odin. Yeah, let's not forget the little girl too before I go to the Cathedral Ward. So we're going to go here, and unfortunately this girl, if you send her to Erden Chapel, she essentially tries to get there, but because she's a little girl, she can't make it. She gets found by a beast, and then she dies. And we're going to get the evidence of her death, unfortunately. The red messenger ribbon that I told you guys before. We're going to go down here. It's going to be these fuckers again. Should I take care of them, or should I just ignore them? What to do? Whatever, let me just take care of you again. Kill you. Continuously kill you. Give me a Bloodstone Shard for once. Okay, so this dude, it's whip time. That's what you need to die. Okay, and this guy, Blood Vials, and this dude, Blood Vials once again. So took care of them, and what we're going to do now is we're going to go here, and should I fight these guys too? Why not? Go for a visceral. Oh shit, that failed. But I mean, I guess the other guy died anyway. So go for it. Success. And he's out too. And then all of these guys died as well. He threw the ball. Like, if you come from this direction, they always die. So you can just do the trick that way. But I can also kill them from the front with the bowling ball. But anyway, now we're going to come down this ladder. And you guys remember this pig or hippo? Unfortunately, it is the monster that kills a little girl. After we kill it, we're going to get the blood vials this guy always drops. And we're also going to get the red messenger ribbon of the girl. So visceral attack inside of your asshole, and this thing is gonna die. Get our blood vials, and then get the red messenger ribbon. So this is the evidence that this thing killed the girl. And no matter what you do, I mean, if you send her to Odin Chapel, she's never gonna be there. And as for this area, I briefly mentioned it, but it's essentially just a giant hole. You fall and you die. There's nothing over there. And I think this is going to do it for this episode. We killed Father Gascoigne. Ended the sad story of the girl and her family. Tragic story, but that's basically the whole thing with this game. Everything goes wrong. No matter what you do, everything is going to go wrong. And got a few things. Unlocked the next stage, the next area, and got a little bit of insight too from the mean old grandma bitch, sent her to Yusefka. So you guys are going to see more characters. Most of them, well, not most of them, but half and half, we're going to send them to Erden Chapel. And there's another prick that I'm actually going to send to Yusefka too. Or two pricks maybe. But anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. Subscribe to the channel, leave a like, share this video with your friends, And I'll see you guys next time. Wasabi.